I'm joined now by James Rice in Arizona. He's a planetary scientist and the geology team leader on the Mars Exploration Rover Project. Big week for space. We're talking about India, China, Russia, the EU joining forces. Tiangong 2 launched in 2016, of course, returning to Earth in a controlled demolition late last week. And of course, we've all been commemorating the 50-year anniversary of Apollo 11. Pretty heady times for people who like space like yourself, I would think.
Yes, indeed. And it's a pleasure to be here with you to discuss these things. It's a busy time, especially around the moon these days.
Let me ask you about the space race we're witnessing today. Lots of documentaries last week about the Apollo mission. Even back in the 60s, JFK was talking about collaboration to kind of defray the cost, actually working with the Soviet Union. So this China-Russia European effort makes perfect sense, doesn't it?
Well, early stages, it does. And it's, you know, it's still a ways off for fruition to come to be. And but I think everybody's realizing the moon is coming back into focus for our future exploration plans of the solar system. The moon for a while had been forgotten for several decades after the Apollo program. And it's really it's blazing right now.
Why do you think that was?
Well, I think after the Apollo missions, obviously, it was the space race of the 1960s, the U.S. versus Soviet Union. That was, the moon was the finish line, you know, at, by the end of the decade. And we achieved that and defeated the Soviet Union. They never even got anybody near the moon, much less landing on the surface of the moon. And I think that when the results came back, the moon looked like just a dried up cratered ball, old cratered, you know, surface. But a lot has changed in those decades that we've learned about the moon, especially the most exciting thing, I think, was probably the discovery of water ice in these permanently shadowed craters in the polar regions of the moon.
And so the Indian mission is the first mission to the South Pole. I mean, it's obviously, the moon is huge, and we're also seeing China, it's gone to the far side of the moon. So talk to me about those different dimensions, hitting different areas of the moon. What does that tell us?
Well, the Chinese mission landed back in the first couple days of January, about 7 months ago. And on the far side, as you mentioned, that was the first mission ever to land on the far side of the moon. And they've got a rover, I don't know if I pronounce it right, U-2-2. It's the second rover the Chinese have landed on the moon with a lander also. And it's been exploring that area of Von Karman crater on the lunar far side and making some discoveries. So, you know, whenever you fly a mission to an uncharted region, you're going to learn something because no one has ever been there before. And by the nature of it, you're going to learn through the exploration discovery. Probably the biggest discovery possibly so far that's being talked about from that mission is identification of possible mantle material from the moon, from the impacts in the area over there. It's still not 100% sure if that is mantle material, but appears right now to be one big discovery. And the mission is ongoing, so it's not over. It still plans for, you know, future discoveries. The Indian Chandrayaan-2 mission, which is due to land on September 7th, as you said, near the South Pole, around 70 degrees south latitude. And it's going to have a lander, the Vikram lander, and there's a little rover in there also called Pragyan. And this is supposed to deploy the rover, and the lander and the rover is supposed to last about 14 Earth days. And we've never landed, as you mentioned earlier, we've never landed. No one has ever been to the polar regions of the moon on the surface. The Chinese mission on the far side, I think it's like around latitude minus 42 to 45. So it's still kind of in the mid-latitudes. But the Indian mission is going to be way down south, 70 south, and on the near side. So I'm looking forward to that because we just don't know, once again, what we're going to see. Just like the Chinese mission in January, you're always excited to see something land in a region we've never been to. You never know what the images are going to show. So as a scientist, it's very exciting. But the polar regions of the moon, those are going to be the focus for the next several decades for all nations of the Earth that are planning to go there because of the resources I mentioned earlier, the water in these permanently shadowed craters.
That's a fascinating time. Great. It's almost kind of a new global age. James, thanks so much for joining us. We really love your insights. Appreciate it.